Hello, my name is Stephanie Chan. I'm a worldwide go-to-market security program specialist. Today, we are talking about GuardDuty runtime monitoring and GuardDuty's latest protection plans, including malware protection for S3. As AWS workloads evolve, new accounts are added, resources are spun up, and zero-day vulnerabilities emerge. AWS workloads need centralized visibility to understand and enhance overall security monitoring. Amazon GuardDuty is the foundational threat detection service for AWS. It's a fully managed service that covers a broad range of AWS workloads. Using machine learning, GuardDuty establishes a baseline of normal behavior that detects anomalous or potentially malicious threats in the form of a finding. GuardDuty's rapid development has expanded its coverage across multiple resources, incorporating both internal and external threat feeds, and making it accessible for businesses of all sizes. Tens of thousands of customers worldwide utilize GuardDuty to discover potential threats in their AWS environment. Now, let's explore how GuardDuty's extensive threat detection applies to your AWS workloads. The service team has launched a series of protection plans offering configurability and granularity. When enabled, GuardDuty will automatically collect only the most relevant security events across the backplane, manage all infrastructure in the AWS service account, and enable the runtime level agents necessary for end-to-end threat detection designed to not disrupt existing resource or account-based logging. GuardDuty's protection plans enhance threat detection across AWS environments, leveraging threat intelligence from third-party vendors and from AWS, including Mythra, the internal neural network graph model that uses algorithms for threat intelligence, and MadPot, the Amazon-owned network of honeypots. Alerts are generated on stateless and stateful rules along with AI/ML algorithms to identify suspicious patterns with 175 types of findings. There are 6 GuardDuty protection plans: S3 protection, EKS protection, malware protection, RDS protection, Lambda protection, and runtime monitoring. Customers get a 30 days free trial per protection plan, per account, per region, even if they already use foundational GuardDuty. Amazon GuardDuty runtime monitoring continuously monitors Amazon EC2, ECS on Fargate, and EKS. AWS streamlined this with automated agent management using lightweight eBPF agents for EKS with add-on deployment options, ECS sidecars, and default SSMs for EC2 instances. This lets customers focus on security without operational overhead. GuardDuty runtime monitoring enhances visibility into network activities and file access, providing timely alerts on potential threats. It tracks activities at the container level, offering insights into command line arguments and context for quicker responses. AWS currently has over 36 dedicated findings for runtime detections, including malware infections, crypto mining, command line monitoring, and remote code execution. While foundational GuardDuty covers similar threats, runtime monitoring provides earlier detection, allowing for quicker action. The expansion of malware protection allows you to scan S3 buckets. This fully managed capability detects, tags, and allows you to quarantine malware, addressing issues related to untrusted uploads. When you enable malware protection for an S3 bucket, it monitors new uploads for malware, triggering scans on the S3 put object API. This capability is designed for simplicity, requiring minimal configuration. Developers and security teams can mandate malware scanning without managing the underlying infrastructure. It's essential for applications where data provenance cannot be established, as it helps prevent malware from entering your environment. GuardDuty will monitor new uploads in configured buckets. If malware is detected, GuardDuty generates a finding along with an object-level tag. Customers can use Lambda functions to move infected tagged objects to a quarantine bucket or restrict access based on TBAC, or tagging-based access controls. You don't need foundational GuardDuty enabled to use this feature. If you have an AWS account with an S3 bucket, you can implement GuardDuty malware protection even without foundational monitoring. This allows application owners to follow security team-approved protocols. Simplicity is central to GuardDuty's expansions and opt-in protection plans. For instance, GuardDuty S3 protection monitors data plane APIs, like GetObject or PutObject, to detect data exfiltration by establishing normal baselines. With a single click, you can enable continuous monitoring for all S3 buckets. Similarly, EKS protection helps you detect potential security risks in Amazon Elastic Kubernetes service clusters in your environment. For example, detecting a misconfigured cluster being accessed by an unauthenticated actor who attempts to collect secrets or credentials from the cluster. GuardDuty RDS protection detects login-based threats for Amazon Aurora databases by analyzing normal login patterns. It offers visibility into anomalous access attempts and extends this capability to RDS PostgreSQL, ensuring comprehensive protection. Once a delegated administrator enables these features, GuardDuty continuously monitors all databases, establishing baselines and detecting abnormalities. As customers enable new opt-in protection plans, GuardDuty automatically collects the necessary telemetry with no need for the customers to enable new log sources. To enable GuardDuty with a delegated administrator account for managing protection plans across your AWS organization, you can follow these steps. Log into your AWS management account and navigate to the GuardDuty console by searching for GuardDuty. If GuardDuty isn't already enabled, click the Get Started button in the top right corner. Review the service role permissions created for GuardDuty. Note that additional permissions are required for GuardDuty malware protection. To delegate an administrator account, enter the 12-digit account ID and click Delegate. This will enable GuardDuty in your management account and set the delegated account accordingly. If you want to manage multiple accounts and protection plans centrally, first make sure you're in the same organization as all managed accounts. After logging into your dedicated administrator account, open the GuardDuty console and click on Accounts. The Accounts table displays all the accounts in your organization. By clicking the Edit button, you can manage your auto-enable preferences, like auto-enabling Amazon GuardDuty for all accounts or new accounts within your organization. Here, you can auto-enable protection plans in your organization as well. Now, let's look at how GuardDuty uses tag-based access controls to isolate malware. We'll set up a bucket for monitoring. Clean objects will be moved to a production bucket, while infected ones go to an isolated bucket. When enabling malware protection for S3, select a staging bucket and define which objects to scan. You can tag objects and set IAM rules for GuardDuty to manage tagging and moving actions. In our demo, there's an upload bucket with two files, an ICAR zip file identified as malware and a test Word document. After uploading, GuardDuty scans and moves them to the appropriate buckets. The Word document is moved to the clean bucket that we set up, and the ICAR file is moved to the infected bucket, and it's tagged for threats found. GuardDuty creates a finding that details the infected file, associated account, and severity level. This information is also streamed to EventBridge, enabling downstream orchestration with Lambda or step functions. And that concludes our demo and overview of GuardDuty. I hope you found this information valuable. For more details, contact your AWS account team or email us at aws-detection-and-response@amazon.com. Thank you for watching.